welcome back to my channel. It's Ashleigh here, and if you are new, hey girl, hey. So today's video is sponsored by TopCashBack. And if you don't know what TopCashBack is, it is a site where you can go online and purchase things and get your money back. So it's super simple to actually sign up for TopCashBack. All you have to do is plug in an email address, add your password, and you're all set to shop at the over 4,000 stores that they have on their site. So they have Target, Walmart, Lowe's, Home Depot, Hobby Lobby, Kirkland's, you name it, they have it on there. Amazon, they have that on there as well. And you can earn your money back. So all you have to do is simply find a store that you want to shop at. So we're going to use Dollar Tree in this instance. And on Dollar Tree site, you can get 4% cash back. And all you have to do is click on it and it will guide you to their site. And then you are ready to shop. So for Dollar Tree, you can choose larger or you can choose the smaller quantities. And if you want to choose smaller quantities, all you have to do is go right up into pick and pack. And then it will take you to another section to where you can choose from the different decor items or sections. I don't know what I'm talking about. Sections. And then you can choose from there. And you can choose from like 2, 4, 6. I think it's like even numbers that you can choose from. And you don't have to get the larger quantities. And you will get that sent to your store. And you will get your cash back. So down below, I'm gonna have a link to where you can click on it, and your first $25 that you spend, you will get $10 back to you, and that expires on December 31st. So if you are doing Christmas shopping, Cyber Monday, any of that stuff, Black Friday, literally, because I don't wanna be out there with all those people, I already have something in my cart for Walmart, you wanna go on to TopCashBack so you can get your money back for your purchases. So with that, we're going to start with our first DIY. Let's go. For the first DIY, you're going to need the glass cylinder vase and also one of the glass storage jars that you can get from the Dollar Tree. And then the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to remove that label from the bottom using my razor. The next thing that I did was I removed the top from the glass storage jar and I removed the plastic part at the bottom. And then I'm going to take my E6000 and I'm going to add that to the bottom of the top of that glass. And then I'm going to add that to the top of my vase. Now what you want to do is you want to make sure that you have this at like eye level so you can make sure that it's centered all the way around the top. Alright, so you can choose to leave this like this if you want, but I'm going to add twine to the top so that it will match the base that I'm going to be using. And to do that, I'm just going to use my hot glue and my scissors to attach this to the top. The next thing that I'm going to be using is this little LED Christmas tree that you can pick up from the Dollar Tree. And I am going to spray paint this. Now it does change color, so if you want to keep it as is, you can totally do that. But I'm going to be using my Heirloom white and I'm going to spray both of these Christmas trees. Alright, so then I took this cute little candle holder. These actually come in a pack that you can get from Hobby Lobby. I'll have it linked down below if I can, but I'm just going to attach that to the bottom using my hot glue. I spray painted it to match my Christmas tree, just to give this Christmas tree a little bit more height. So I love, like, these are literally, I think, one of my favorites that I did in these DIYs, and I love the birched wood that I picked up from Hobby Lobby. I believe they were like $1.49 a piece, and then it just matches perfectly with the Christmas trees and the vases that I used with the tops. So these will be perfect for a fireplace mantle, your island, a TV stand, wherever you want to add these, they will look amazing. Moving along to DIY number two, so we're going to be using this tinseled reindeer that you can pick up from the Dollar Tree, and I am going to remove the tinsel. So if you're a person that loves tinsel, don't get your tinsel in a twist because I'm removing it. Oh my god, that was so cheesy. But I'm just going to remove this. All you have to do is snip away and unravel. So after that, you're gonna have two separate pieces of your reindeer, and to attach those back, I'm just gonna be using my hot glue and I'm gonna attach that right back together. And then the antlers, I'm gonna do that same thing and attach it with my hot glue. The next step is taking some twine that I picked up from Walmart. I love to get their twine because it's very inexpensive. It's like $2, well, $2.78 or something like that for the twine. And I'm just gonna start to wrap this whole reindeer with the twine. So the twine that I'm using is a smaller twine than the larger twine roll that you can get from Walmart. So to add a little bit more character to my reindeer, I'm going to take this buffalo check ribbon that I got from Joanns, and I'm gonna wrap that around its neck and then snip off what I don't need. So now I'm gonna take my favorite stain, which you guys know, it is Briar Smoke by Rust-Oleum, and I am going to stain this little circular wood piece that I got from Michael's that was only 99 cents. So after my wood stain is nice and dry, I am going to attach my reindeer using my hot glue, but I would recommend using E6000 to attach this to the base. Okay, so I am loving how this reindeer turned out. OMG, he is wrapped in twine because twine not. You guys know I love me some twine. So I was super excited that I got to wrap this reindeer with the twine, and he looks really good. So this would be perfect to put anywhere in your home for the holiday season. Moving along to the third DIY, so what you're gonna need to pick up is the craft paper or postal paper from the Dollar Tree, and then you can just use any books that you have lying around in your house. So the next step is taking your postal paper and wrapping your books up like they are presents. So if you are a bomb gift wrapper, then you can make this look phenomenal. I would recommend probably using like double-sided tape for the side so you won't see the glossiness from the actual tape. And then I'm just going to take some of the larger twine that I got from Walmart, and I am going to wrap this horizontally and vertically and just glue it, making sure I'm pulling really taut to the back and snipping off the excess twine. So now I'm gonna start to decorate, and to do that I'm gonna be using these sprigs that you can get from Target Bullseye, and also this other little ornament. They both were $1, and then I am going to add the sprig and then also this key, which I removed from the original leather ribbon that it was on. And then I'm adding it to some twine. And then I just added my sprig to the back with some hot glue. And then I just put that key on the top of that sprig. I'm loving the simplicity of this DIY. Literally all you need is some craft paper and books that you already have in your house, and just add some cute little stuff to the top. And this is ready to add to your home for the holidays. Okay, so for this last DIY, I'm literally using the storage jars that I used in the very first DIY, and I'm spray painting them that Heirloom white. And then all I'm gonna do is take some twine and I'm gonna wrap that around the top. And then I'm going to glue that using my hot glue. So after that, I just picked up these trees from the Target Bullseye. They were $3 a piece, and I'm going to remove them from their base and I'm gonna add it to the jars. And to do that, I don't have my floral foam, so I'm just caking on some hot glue and then I'm adding that to the center of the jar. So this DIY was super quick to do, and it was a really good way to kind of just repurpose those jars that I took the tops off. So I just spray painted them. You can distress these if you would like. And then you just add just whatever tree you want to in the inside, and you can put these anywhere in your home. I'm honestly obsessed with all of these. They were so simple to make, and they are just so my style. So if you've been with me for a while, you know my style, and this is it.
All right, so that's the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, as always, make sure you give this video a big thumbs up. Make sure you comment down below to let me know what you think. Also, if you're not a part of TopCashBack, make sure you click on that link down below so you can start earning money today. If you have not got on my email list yet, make sure you get on that email list. Again, I have a special offer coming up that I'm super excited about. If you haven't checked out my latest video, you can check it out up here. And if you're not subscribed, make sure you click on that subscribe button, and I will see you in my next one.